Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's begin to worship the Lord tonight. Begin to bless His name and exalt Him. Give Him all the glory and all the honor. Just worship Him. Just worship Him. Give Him praise. Our God is beautiful. Our God is glorious. He's full of so much love. Father, we thank You. We exalt You. We exalt You. Just begin to worship Him where you are. Begin to give Him praise. Glorify His holy name. Just glorify Him. Give Him all the glory. Give Him all the honor. He alone is worthy to be praised. Father, we thank You. We thank You. We bless Your holy name, O God. We exalt Your holy name, O God. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy to be exalted. Just give Him praise, give Him praise, give Him praise. Thank Him for His goodness in your life. Thank Him for His goodness. Our God is good. The psalmist said He's good and His mercy endures forever. Just thank Him for His goodness, for His goodness. He's such a God of great, great love, and He's so faithful. He's so faithful. He's good, He's good, and His mercy endures forever. God never wishes us evil. There is no evil in Him. He takes no pleasure in wickedness. Just thank Him. Now begin to invite His presence. Tonight, Father, I want Your presence. I want You to fill me up tonight with the Holy Spirit. Begin to ask God for the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God. Father, fill us up tonight. Fill us up tonight. With Your Spirit, with Your Spirit. We ask for an infilling. We want a flow of the rivers of living water, the rivers of Your Spirit out of our belly tonight, Lord. Fill us up tonight, Jesus. We ask for an infilling of the Holy Spirit. Pour it upon us. Jesus said, your parents who are evil know how to give you good gifts when you call upon Him. How much more shall my heavenly Father in heaven give you the Holy Spirit when you ask? Just ask tonight. Father, the Holy Spirit, we are asking for an infilling. We are thirsty for Your Spirit, oh God. We are thirsty. We are thirsty for the Holy Ghost. We are thirsty, Father. We want to experience Him in a new way, in a new dimension, oh Lord. We want to experience the Holy Spirit in a new dimension, Father. Tonight, fill us up. Fill us up. Fill us up, Father. Fill us up with Your Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Now begin to ask the Lord to touch you. Touch you by the Holy Ghost. Let the Holy Spirit touch you. Let the Holy Ghost touch you. Touch your heart. Touch your body. Touch your soul. Touch your ministry. Touch your family. The Holy Spirit. Tonight, Father, touch us with the Holy Spirit. Just come and touch us. We surrender to the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Ah, Shabalatu Sakataya Balataya Kataya. Zibropoto Seketeya Pato Shataya. We surrender to the anointing of the Holy Spirit tonight, Lord. Let there be a rain of the Holy Spirit tonight. In the name of Jesus, a rain of Your Spirit, Lord. A rain, let it come down. Mighty rain of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Father. Faithful God, loving God, we thank You. We thank You for the release of the Holy Spirit tonight. The baptism of the Holy Ghost. Sagabado shagabadaya kadayaba. Zide zibro dozozo legete. Latabataya badalabada sosola paya. Ikato sekete. Arito saprata satabayata. Ikabababa. Thank You for this wonderful gift. The gift of the Holy Ghost is the love of God. Is the love of God. The gift of the Holy Spirit is the love of God. We receive Him tonight. What a privilege to be endued with the Holy Spirit. To be endued with the gift of God. Thank You, Father, for this love. thank you, Father, for this love, counting us worthy to carry the Spirit of God, to be sealed with the Holy Spirit. We thank God for the privilege in the name of Jesus. Now begin to ask God to minister to me tonight personally. Speak to my spirit tonight personally. Lord, speak to my spirit tonight personally. Speak to me. Communicate with my spirit. Help me, Father, to catch a rhema of your word tonight. I want a word that will speak to my spirit, Lord. Come and fill me up with this word. Reveal something to me tonight, God. In the name of Jesus. Leta pataya taso pataya kataya patu satai. Riko potu sika katasi koprotu sikete. We receive a word from the mouth of the Lord tonight. Shabarito soko paragataya. Leketekete soprotu yakata. Now this word can be to you a word of healing. For the Lord sent a word, and the word healed them and delivered them from all their destructions. The word of God is a healing word. It brings healing. It brings deliverance. Let that word come tonight. Let that word come tonight. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we ask for it. We ask for the word that will heal our spirit, the word of Father that will heal our soul, the word that will heal our flesh. Every area of our life shall be healed in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Dearly beloved, I want you to know that God means well for you. The Bible says every good and perfect gift is from the Father above, from the Father of lights. And a man can receive nothing except it be given to him by God. A man can receive nothing. Every good and perfect gift is from the Lord above. Hallelujah. I want you to know, dearly beloved, that God is not a man that he will lie. God means you well. He said, above all things, I wish that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. So God wants you to prosper in your career. God wants you to prosper in your business. And God wants you to prosper in the spirit as well, in your soul. You are rich in your work on this earth. You are rich in your secular work. And you are also rich in your spiritual work. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The word that the Lord has put in my spirit is to preach about, very briefly, because it's a prayer service, about receiving His love. Because there can be doubt in the hearts of people about whether God truly loves them. People may begin to ask questions. You know, does God really love me? And this is where the problem is, because until we receive the love, we can't enjoy the benefits of the love. Until we receive the love of Jesus, the love of God, it's difficult for us to really be fulfilled in our spirit. If we don't believe in a thing, we can't benefit from it. The truth of the matter, dearly beloved, is that before you were born, God was thinking of you. Praise the Lord. Before you were conceived, God was thinking of you. He said to Jeremiah that before you were born, I knew thee. And before you came out, I sanctified thee. So it means that there's already preparation for you before you were born. And after you were born, God was still with you and is still with you. He said, you were born from the womb. Isaiah 46. You were born by Him from the womb. And that you have been raised even till you had gray hairs. Praise the Lord. So God understands everything about you, dearly beloved. Don't be worried. Don't be concerned about the calamities, the evil around you. What you should be concerned about is the love of God. Be focused on the love of God and be convinced in your heart that He loves you. He said, even when you were dead in sins and trespasses, Christ died for you. Praise the Lord. You know the love, the mercy of the Lord, and His great love that He loves us, that even when we were dead in sins and trespasses, Jesus died for you. Praise the Lord. The Bible says He commended His love for us. So we did not merit it. We were sinners. We were dead in sin. But the love of God, that love that cannot be, it is incomprehensible, that love prevailed. And the Bible says Jesus Christ died for us, not of our works, for anyone we boast. Ephesians chapter 2. He said, it is not of your good works, but by the grace of God. Hallelujah. Ephesians 2 verse 8, for by grace you are saved through faith. Not because of yourself or what you have done, but he said, it is the gift of God. The gift of God. Hallelujah. You see, if you don't receive this love, and if you don't believe it, you will remain inferior. The reason why I said that is because you will doubt yourself. And when someone begins to doubt himself, inferiority complex begins to come in. Praise the Lord. So we have this issue around Black Lives Matters. We have this issue around discrimination, racism. People feel that they are being trampled upon, that, you know, some people are better off than them. Dearly beloved, it's because they have not received the love of God. When you have the love in you, when you receive the love of God in you, then you cannot be discriminated against. You see, man may discriminate against you, but God, who created all of us equal, will never discriminate against you. When you are assured of God's love, your foot is not moved. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. When you are sure of the love that God has for you, your foot is not moved. God's love is God's presence. David said, I have set him at my side. I will not be moved. When the love of God is in you, the Spirit of God is working. When you believe it and you receive it and you are walking in this love, then the Spirit of God is active. You have to be assured and confident of the love that God has for you. Praise the Lord. And be unshaken, be unmoved. In Ephesians chapter 3, Paul prayed a prayer for us from verse 14. And this prayer is very important because we need to receive the love if we are going to benefit from the love. Hallelujah. He said, for this cause I bow my knees unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in the heaven and the earth is named, that He would grant you, according to the riches of His glory, to be strengthened with might by His Spirit in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye may be rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth and the length and the depth and the height. Praise the Lord. And to know the love of Christ which passeth knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God. If we don't the love, if we are not grounded in the love of God through Jesus Christ, we cannot really be fulfilled. So Paul was praying and saying that he bows himself, he bows his knees to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying for us that we may be rooted and grounded in the love of God, so that we may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the height, what is the length, what is the breadth of the love of God, which passeth understanding, passeth all knowledge, then we be fulfilled, be filled with the fullness of God. God does not mean anyone evil. Praise the Lord. Understand that any situation that you are passing through that doesn't bear the mark of God, it's not God. God means you love and means you well. You will be well in Jesus' name. You will be strong in the name of Jesus. You will not fear again in the name of Jesus. You will be strengthened with might in your inner man in the name of Jesus. He means you well. He said that you may comprehend with all the saints what is the height of this love. To know the love of Christ which passeth knowledge. You know, one way we can really truly know the love of God is if we come to the cross. If we believe, or if we can open up ourselves to that experience in the cross. And this is what Paul calls dying in Christ. Dying in Christ to understand, to perceive the suffering of Christ. When we can die in Christ, then we'll be able to perceive more this love we're talking about. I had one revelation where I saw the moment Jesus Christ was being pierced and how he screamed on the cross. It was real pain. When we can come to that moment of having that experience in our spirit of the cross, then we'll begin to understand the love of God for us. He said, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Praise God. He did not come that we are condemned, but by through him we are saved. Hallelujah. James said that, let no man deceive himself when he is tempted of evil, to say that it is God. But that when a person is drawn to his lust, a person is tempted when he's drawn away by his lust. And when lust is conceived, then death comes. But God's will is not for us to be condemned, but by through Jesus Christ that we may have life. So Paul is saying, I'm praying for you to understand this love that God has for you. He doesn't want you to perish. God is not interested in your destruction. Look, dearly beloved, it's time for you to begin to look at what is ahead of you and let go of that past that is trying to destroy your life. And this is what Paul also said again in Philippians chapter 3. This man understood clearly this love. He said that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. Philippians chapter 3 and verse 10. That I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made conformable unto his death. For if by any means I might attain unto the resurrection of the dead, not as though I had already attained, either we are already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of Jesus Christ. I count not myself to have apprehended. But this one thing I do, one thing I do know, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth for those things which are before, I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. If you are not grounded in the love of God, you will not be able to receive forgiveness and mercy. You will continue to self-judge yourself, and you will continue to live in guilt. Look, Paul is saying, forget about that past and begin to reach out to the high calling of God. There's a crown that awaits you. Look, temptation is real. Everyone will be tempted. There is nobody that will not be tempted. Even Jesus Christ was tempted. Everyone will be tempted. But James said that there is a crown to them that will overcome such temptations. Don't self-condemn yourself by temptations, by guilt, and by sorrow. Come out of it. Receive the love that God has for you, and determine to make amends today. You see, Jesus, the writer of Hebrews, said in Hebrews 9:22 that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. That is, without the blood of Christ, there is no forgiveness. On the cross of Calvary, Jesus shed his blood. On that cross, what he was saying is, I love you. I love you. Although there was pain, as he was being pierced by those nails, as he was being crucified, untold pain, but in the midst of his eyes was love. In the midst of his eyes, he loved you. Yourself to a position of disrepute and begin to say, because of what happened in the past, that is why I'm suffering in the present, is the trap of the devil. Align yourself to God. Now, what has this love done? The love has delivered you from the power of darkness and translated you to the kingdom of his dear son Jesus. The Bible says that he has made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light. That we are seated together with Jesus in heavenly places. Hallelujah. Jesus does not expect us to live in sin when we receive the love. 1 John chapter 3. He said there is a seed in them, the seed of righteousness. And for this reason, he was made manifest to destroy the works of the devil. The Bible says that he was bruised for our iniquities. He was wounded for our transgressions. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, we are made whole. The word of God is not a lie. The problem is that we have people refuse to believe it and to walk in it. You know, we cannot be slaves to sin, because the grace of God is strong enough to empower us to say no. Look, Jesus has washed our sins. It's not a right to fall in sin and to live in sin. You don't say my sins are covered because Jesus died for me, therefore I can't commit any sin. No. But what I'm saying is, if you are falling in any sin yesterday, come to the cross today and begin to live a new life tomorrow. Stop looking at the past to determine your future. He said, look not on the former things or on the things of old, for I will do a new thing, and it shall spring forth, shall ye not know it? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. There is nowhere the mercy of God cannot penetrate. He said, how can a suckling mother forget his son who is hungry? That is how your father is. A woman who is breastfeeding, the child is crying for breast milk, and he looks at the child and turns his face? No. Can a son ask his father for bread, and the father will give him stone? This is what he was saying. So also the Lord God, who loves you, will not turn his back from you when you cry to him. Hallelujah. Is there an area in your life where you are struggling? Come to the cross. Come to Jesus and seek his help. Looking unto Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith. When they looked unto him, they were lightened, and their faces were no longer ashamed. He said, I look unto the hills, from whence cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord who is above. There's still a chance for you to make amends. There's still a chance for you to come to the blood of Jesus to cleanse you of that sin, to wash you and purify you. Hallelujah. He came not that we be condemned, not to condemn, but that through him we might be saved. The Bible says, to save them, to save that which was lost. That's what Jesus came. That's what he came for. When the prodigal son saw the son coming, he raised his arm and welcomed the son, killed the fattest calf and made a feast. God's arms are open to anyone that wants to come into this love. Anyone that wants to come into it. And truthfully speaking, to them that receive him, that receive the love, to them he has given power to be called the sons of God. His word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. If you truly believe, come today. Come and be grounded in this love. Be unmovable and unshakable. Troubles will come, trials will come, but that doesn't mean that God's love is forgotten. In the wilderness, the children of Israel cried to the Lord. In their thirst, in their hunger, in their dryness, they cried. And in their distress, they cried and sought the Lord, and God answered them. If you are passing through dryness, if you are passing through the wilderness, doesn't mean that God is non-existent or his love is eroded. The love is there. The Lord is powerful. The love cannot be moved. It's incomprehensible. But when you are grounded, then you can have some understanding of this love that God has for you. Say, Father, thank you for your love for my life. Thank you, Father, for this love that you have for me. I receive this love today Father, help me to be grounded in it. Help me, Father, to be grounded in your love for me. In the name of Jesus, Lord, help me to be grounded in your love for my life. I receive the love of God and I live and dwell in his love. Begin to ask the Lord, help me to abide in your love. Help me, Father, to live and abide in your love, to walk in your love, to live in your love. Help me, Father. Help me, O God, not to be separated from your love. Help me, Father, to dwell in the depth of your love. Shatus kitebe de gede ya padiga daya brado so brodo koto de gede palika daya kete bete kete kete kete. Somebody ask the Lord, zagaba gada bado shagada badaba yezi bro popotozo protozo, to abide in your love, to dwell in your love, to live in your love, to be grounded in your love. Isekete kete, paketo sekete, ikabate sekete, rata da da bada soso, magada ya bata, ikebegede so. Let the challenges of life not separate me, not cause me to derail from the power of your love. Inda da bada bosha, ikada bada bada bosha. Mekada bada bosha, ikada bada bada bada, mekete soprete, ikopoto sekete, anda bada bosete, mado sekete bosete, masiko poto soto, asaka bakataya, ebrakataya katabada, mekuto soko potolo, ikebrekete sekete, masuko te sekete, asoko poto koto, to be grounded in his law, begeto parata, ekabagada soso. Antico prakataya, bekido sokotolia, ikabagada badosa, ekendo sekete. Help me, O God, to be grounded in the power of your love. In the gadabadosa, bani kopoto zozo, ambragada badabadosa, ikabagada badaba. Mazuko tolo proto, ikede, 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 angabagada badosa. Ikada gadabada, indalabo sekete, begele kete, iprokopotozo, ikabagado sekete, intako, 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 shata kata katolo poto, ikata pakotose, ikabedede, into sekete gede, palapala palo sadabaya, ibraga baba boshakata. Bade poroto soto boto, ikabara pato soboto, isekepeke tezuzi, the power of his love, the palapada zozo, gati soproto, ikepeke tezu, ikoboto. Thank you, Father. Lord, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You see, the love of God is not a respecter of persons. Anyone whose heart is open, who is ready to receive, God is ready to release. Peter said, I perceive my heart. God is not a respecter of persons. Both the Gentiles and the Jews were all open to receive the word of God, which is the love of God. And as they did, the Holy Spirit came upon them mightily. Acts chapter 10, 44 down. And they began to speak in the language of the Holy Spirit. Because they received, they were open to this love. They received Jesus. And the power of the Spirit of God came upon all of them. If you are open and ready to receive, amen, his power, the power of the Spirit of God is going to be released upon you. Just open up Say, Father, tonight I open up my spirit to receive your love. I open up my spirit, O Lord, to receive the love of Jesus who died on the cross of Calvary. I receive him tonight. Take root in my heart. Take root in my spirit. Let the love of God take root. I want to abide in the vine. I abide in the vine. Make me a branch, O Lord. I want to stick to Jesus. I stick to Jesus. I abide in him. No matter the situation, no matter the condition, I abide in him. I dwell and live in him. I come, but today, Father, I open up my spirit. Come and take your place. Santa Catalia. Pegodo sente ikata pandegede suprido sadabaya ikoto soto sate kadabode pagadabado sataba. Nothing will distract me. Sakapataya ikedo soto bedegete debodo soto. I receive him today. Abapalapata nekabata lapata riko bobobosa ikabadabadaba magundo sikataba. Receive him today. Shikapados etilo inkendolo bosintolo made secondolo ikaborotsoso masekete ikobodosete satabadabodos ikadabedosha taba mikadosekete ikobodobodobodosha madindolo bosoto ikabelebedosata ikabadabayata saboroboshekete. Somebody, receive your deliverance. Receive the deliverance. Asata patabada soto intembe debo shataba. Kigalete ketedi ikadabada badosi ikebede debe debe de ikadabada soso mikadate atada ikenezo dozo mazi ketelia madabadosa ente ketekede de bala 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 dosoto bagadabadaba. Somebody is receiving rest. Sambada badabada badosha matakada zaba Bosha, Nikadabadabadabosha, Mande Seco Poto, Ikadabadoso, so Ikedem Gedegede, Rapatayabada. Thank you, Father. I receive rest for my soul. I receive peace. He said, the chastisement of our peace was upon him. He said, in his word, if you put your trust in me, you will have peace. You will have rest. But in the world, you will have tribulation. Oh, be of good cheer, because I've overcome it all. Everything, every pain, every trouble you will ever go through, Jesus said, I've overcome everything on the cross. Just come unto me and I will give you rest. I will take the labor off. I will take that labor, that burden, I will take it off. I will take that yoke off you. I will take it off. I will take it off tonight. In the labor, Migandala balabalaba shagadala balabosha zigederegederebosha nikandala balabala bosha rekadababosha dabadabadaba zigadada gadabadabadush magine gedegedegede zudo produce gedegedesa daba nikadabadaba. Somebody is receiving it. Receive your rest. Receive your peace. Receive deliverance. Be healed in your body. Be healed in your spirit. Receive it right now. Rata bada 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 bata. Nikada bada 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 bata. Makada bada bada bata. Nakada bada 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 pa. Maseke te te te. Rakata bada bada pa. Zigo bodo bodo bodo. Babi godo sokoto. Anti koto dodo. Bakate ke te te. Receive, receive fresh baptism of the Holy Spirit. It's coming upon you. Be healed right now. In your spirit be healed. In your soul be healed. In your body be healed. In the name of Jesus. Take it right now. Take it right now. Ataka da bada 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 dosha. Mekanda la bada bada bosha. Mande seke deke deke de. Padito sotoloa. Manda sekete. Isuko prokoto. Antaka tabaya. Thank you, Father. Begin to give him praise. Shako koto sotobodo shekete. Antico eti osite. Palata yagada labado sekete. We yada dada bado sekoto se. Father, we worship you.
We bless you, Father. We bless you. We bless you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We exalt you. We exalt you. We glorify you. Thank you, Father, for this great gift, your Son Jesus, whom you gave to us. We thank you. We bless you. Who has seen such goodness? Who has seen such love? Who has seen such mercy? Father, we exalt you. We thank you, Father, for your goodness towards us. We take the praise. Take all the glory, Lord. We are grateful. We appreciate this love. We receive it today, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' precious name. May the blood of Jesus wash away every guilt in your heart. May the blood of Jesus wash away every pain in your spirit. May the blood of Jesus Christ wash away every sickness in your body, every sickness in your spirit, every habitual situation that is bringing you into disrepute. May the blood of Jesus wash it away. Every stronghold in your life, let the blood of Jesus Christ begin to wash it away. Be washed in your body. Be washed in your bloodstream. Be washed in your organs. Be washed in your spirit. Be washed in your mind. Let your heart be washed. Let your soul be washed. Your children are washed. Your husband is washed. Your wife is washed by the blood of Jesus. Be washed right now. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ, be washed right now in the name of Jesus. The Bible makes us to understand that our fellowship is with the Father of lights. And because of that, we are washed by the blood of Jesus. May everything that is not connected to Jesus Christ be washed out of your life. Everything that is not connected to Jesus be washed out of your spirit. He said, whatsoever my Father has not planted shall be rooted out. May everything that is not connected to the blood of Jesus be flushed out of your life right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, everything that is not found in Christ be rooted out of you from the root and swallowed by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, everything that is not connected to the body of Christ, for it is written, we are members of the body of Christ. Our bodies for the Lord and the Lord for the body. He said we are made feet in Christ, who is head over all principalities and powers. Everything not connected to the body of Christ be rooted out of your life. I command the spirit of disappointment rooted out of your life. Every spirit of delay, every spirit of slow motion be rooted out of your life. Every spirit of frustration, spirit of fear, in the name of Jesus, be rooted out of you right now. I decree every spirit of fear, every spirit of oppression, spirit of affliction be rooted out of you right now. Let that spirit of sorrow lose its hold from your life. Let that spirit of tears lose its hold from your life. Every stranger holding you bound, in the name of Jesus, be set free. Be set free. Be set free. Where you do not belong, I command you to come out of that place. He said, Jesus is not here. He's risen. He doesn't belong here. Why do you look for him here? Wherever you do not belong, that you are found in the spirit realm, in the physical, I command you in the name of Jesus, be set free. Come out of that place right now. Be loose from that place in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' precious name. Oh, I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost. The anointing of the presence of God is here. The anointing has come. The anointing that breaks yoke has come. The anointing that exalts. The anointing that favors has come. Ababosha. Zigedede. Sababosha. Kataba. Lakataba. I hear in my spirit that the Lord is beginning to quicken somebody's steps. The Lord wants to quicken your steps. The Holy Spirit is speaking. The Lord is quickening somebody. It's quickening your mind. It's quickening your spirit. It's quickening your steps. Giving you quick steps. Quick steps. Quick steps. Quick steps. In the name of Jesus. The Lord is quickening your steps. Your steps will not be slippery anymore. The ground will not be slippery. The ground will not be slippery. In the name of Jesus Christ, your ground will not be slippery. I decree from this moment, quick steps, quick steps, quick progress, quick progress, quick progress, quick promotion, quick steps in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' precious name. Father, we thank you. Let's thank God for hearing us tonight. Lord, we bless you for what you have done. Thank you, Father. Lord, we worship you. Thank you for what you have done tonight. The entrance of your word giveth light and bringeth understanding to the simple. Whom Jesus Christ has set free is free indeed. Thank you for setting us free from captivity. For shooting us into the depth of your love. For destroying the distractions. Father, we thank you. We give you praise, Lord. We worship you, Father. Be exalted. In Jesus' precious name. I hear in my spirit, God is taking away every inferiority complex from you. Whatsoever makes you feel inferior around people, God is taking it away from you. From this moment, God is putting on you the spirit of boldness. When you come before people, it doesn't matter whether they are white or red. God is giving you favor and boldness. You will be reckoned with amongst men. As long as it is a man, you will be reckoned with. It doesn't matter how rich they are. It doesn't matter who they are. God is going to empower you to be reckoned with. In the name of Jesus, receive that revelation. Receive that prophecy. In Jesus' precious name. It is done for you. In Jesus' name. Amen. I'm Evangelist Emmanuel Ojeme of Liberation Evangelical Ministries. Share this message to somebody who needs this word of hope. Do the work of an evangelist, and the Lord will reward you mightily. In Jesus' name, you are blessed in the name of Jesus. This Sunday, 16:30, we will connect again. Remember, God loves you. God is not interested in your sufferings, but above all things, that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. Have a blessed week. This week, men will favor you because God's favor is upon your life. In Jesus' name, amen.